How to delete your Google account permanently. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into the question. When I retired, I decided I no longer needed a couple of additional email addresses. What I would like to know is how to delete the two Gmail accounts that I no longer want. I don't want to start deleting things without knowing what I'm doing in case I delete my personal account in error, which would be a disaster. Okay, great. I will show you how to delete your Gmail account. However, before we do that, I want you to consider an alternative that is safer and ultimately will have the same effect. But first, before you do anything, I want you to, you can guess, back up. Here's how you do that. So here we are in my Google account. I'm actually signed in as askleo example or askleo test here. The thing to do is go to takeout.google.com. What this is a service of Google that will allow you to download everything associated with your Google account. It downloads your email, your files, your who knows what. You can see that there are, in fact, 45 of 46 selected. The only one that is not selected by default is activity logs, but let's go ahead and turn that on anyway. 46 of 46 selected. I honestly, even if you don't recognize any of these other Google services that are listed here, I strongly recommend you just export them all. If you aren't using them, they're not going to take up any space. But the risk of missing something by picking and choosing is perhaps a little too high and certainly higher than we need to. And you can see here that I did create a download some time ago that I can now download. But if we want to create a new export, then we've got all of these selected, and I believe all the way down at the bottom is the next step. I'm not going to go through this, but basically I'm strongly suggesting you do this. You run takeout.google.com and export everything associated with your account before you delete it. That way, no matter what, you will not have lost anything. The takeout might be a little bit inconvenient, and I've got a way to address that here coming up, but the bottom line is you'll know that it is there. Now, it may take a day or two for the takeout to show up. That's fine. It'll be a very large zip file, and all you really need to do is squirrel that away somewhere. Then we can move on to the next step. My next step is actually not to delete the account. Instead, I recommend that you abandon it. The difference is subtle, but the bottom line is if you abandon it, which means never signing into it ever again, then the account will remain. Everything is there online for some period of time. Eventually, Google will delete it. By eventually, I mean 2 years or something like that. Again, that number is subject to change based on what Google plans to do with inactive accounts, but essentially by abandoning your account, that account becomes inactive and Google will eventually remove it. Why is this important? Well, it's easier than getting something out of your takeout. If after doing this, you realize that, oh gosh, there's this something or other from that account that I really wish I would have grabbed before I deleted it, well, not deleting it solves that, because all you really need to do then is sign into the account, go to wherever it is, whatever it is you want is stored, and grab it. It'll be there for however long Google decides an inactive account will stick around. And yes, accessing it to retrieve something will reset the clock, but that's okay. Now, like I said, I actually strongly recommend that in lieu of deleting, you actually abandon the account. However, I do want you to take some precautions. And by that, I mean I want you to make sure that the account has a long and strong password. 20 random characters is ideal for this. That you make sure you've got account recovery mechanisms set up in that account. And finally, that you seriously consider adding two-factor to the account. So why am I securing the account so tightly? Well, honestly, your accounts generally should be secured this tightly. But the issue is by abandoning the account and leaving it there, there is a tiny chance, a very small but tiny chance, that the account could get hacked. Unless you actually tighten down the security to the point where yeah, it's just not going to happen. So this is one of those things where abandoning the account is my preference. Tighten the security before you do so. Okay, so you've heard all of that and you disagree with me, right? You really, really want to delete this specific account. Here's what I want you to do. The question was posed in a way that clearly says that you have more than one Gmail account. And the concern is that you want to take action on only one of them without accidentally damaging anything in any of the others. That's very easy to do. Step one, fire up a different browser, a browser that you don't normally use. Step two, clear all the cookies in that browser. By definition, clearing all those cookies will log you out of every account that had been signed into in that browser. Then, sign into the account you want to delete. Only the account you want to delete. That way, none of the other accounts are accessible here. The only thing you can operate on is the account you want to delete. Then, here's what we're going to do. We'll go over to your icon, your profile icon in the upper right. Click on that, then click on Manage Your Google Account. Then over here on the left-hand side, click on Data and Privacy. Then scroll down, keep scrolling until you find More Options, where there is an option to delete your Google account. Now, I'm not going to go through this myself because I don't want to delete this account. But if you're serious about truly, permanently deleting your account, that's the path to take. That'll do it. Google may give you like 30 days to change your mind. That's fine. But ultimately, this will get your account deleted permanently more quickly. So ultimately, I prefer you abandon the account, but now you know how to delete it. Regardless of which approach you take, I strongly recommend that you use Google Takeout to preserve anything that might be in that account, just in case. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/163035. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.